Hello YouTube. Qualifying. Sebring TCR Open. Yes. It was the next available race.
Your exit is clear. Watch the white line. Alright Clayton, we've got 2 laps to set a decent time.
Yeah, it was the next available race. So, here we are. I've done a little bit of practice. I've never raced here before, never, not on any game or sim. I'd never watched a race here. The layout was
track
a complete alien.
It's now 25°C.
Oh, Jesus. As you can see with mistakes like that. So yeah, what's the plan? Get to the end. I'm car 12, and to be honest, I don't know if the top 10 is going to be a possibility in this race. So this is probably the most out of my comfort zone I've ever been, probably since I've been on iRacing. This is an open race, but I'm just using the fixed setup. I haven't got a clue on fuel, not a clue, and I'm not smart enough to figure it out. But actually, I might be able to. So, if lap times are 2 minutes, let's say 16 on average for the fast guys, maybe they're in the 15s consistently. How many 2 minute 15s fit into half an hour? I don't know. Well, 15. Less than 15. Okay, so I need 15 laps of fuel. Would that be fair? I need 15 laps, probably closer to 10, but I'd say 14 laps of fuel needed. My consumption is an absolute mystery. So I need 14. That's what I'll work on. The assumption that I need 14 laps of fuel. That's probably too much, but it's better than too much. The last corner. I mean, you can watch it with your eyes. I haven't got a clue what I'm doing. And I got a little spoiler coming up for you. I haven't got a clue how the first corner works either. I have my brake marker, which is this fence. And the fence sort of lines up. Didn't feel fast. Brake just after the three cones. Wide line, this is a very slow corner. It leads onto a decent straight, so you do want to not hit the inside curb like I did if you can help it. Or hit the red limiter, or hit the dirt on the other side. Brake at the four cones. Brake hard. Car come around, we can do a little cut there. Left. I think here you want to brake before the three, probably halfway between the three and the four, in a straight line, hard. Just missed the inside. Oh, I've gone too quick. Had to back out. Didn't want to off track. This is a weird little zigzag as well. Brake at the two. You want to turn in late. Not that late though. I'll not to do it. Curbs have a wide line. They come out, back in, brake before the three cones. This is the corner that's like really deceptive for me. Not that okay. You want to come out wide, let the car turn itself in. Oh, the inside curb isn't set on it. They're doing 2 minutes 14s. Oh wow, I've not even done it. What's happened? I've run out of fuel already. I've not even done one lap. Oh no. Oh dear. Okay. I'm not going to have time. I'm not going to have time to set a lap. Okay. Let's figure out what we need in the pits. What I put in, how many litres did I put in? I put in 5 litres. And that wasn't enough for two laps. So 6 litres would have done us two. I need 14, so I need 7 times 6. So that's 42 litres. I'm going on the assumption that those guys at the front will do lots. I think that's about right. Amazing. Amazing. What a strategy. Well, there's a bliver, early doors. Didn't put enough fuel in. Did I do one lap? No. That was my first flying lap. Right, okay. Wow. Yeah, we're ready to go. Who have we got in the entry list here? I don't think I'm going to recognise many people here. So, who do we recognise? None of them. I've got a bad memory. I've probably raced half of these last week, but I don't remember any of them. All right. I've turned some settings down on the graphics because I was having real issues with the pits. I think when the light gets low, I had this at the Charlotte Roval in the limit of adhesion race. When the lights get low and I go past the pits, just goes nuts.
Fastest lap for Hardy, 2:14.36.
2:14. 2:14.3.
New fastest lap
2:14.15. Wow. Oh no, I'm one of the only people not to set a time. Me and Conrad. I wonder what his middle name is. Could be awkward initials. I think loads of people like this track, and I'm yet to see why. I find it's a bit like driving in an industrial estate. It's not doing anything for me at this early stage. Who knows, maybe the magic of it will come through. Oh, Conrad's on a lap. Put him into, is that 18th? No. Can't figure it out. 12th. So I'm the only one. Oh my. Oh dear. This is what underprepared looks like. 42 litres, okay. I don't want to be the person who asks, hang on, was that a safety car? Are we doing an outlap? That's more fuel, is all I'm thinking. Do we do an outlap in there? We have a start. We start. Yeah, because last week
we
cracked on, didn't we?
Put the back of the leg.
My frame rate's looking good.
Push, Marcelo. Push, Marcelo. Push.
Before, I was getting maybe 50 frames per second in this location. So, to be honest, I've turned all the graphics down. I can't even tell the difference. So, what a waste of energy that was. The Audi is a bit ugly on the inside, isn't it? The only glimpses that we're in a Formullama car is the bright colours out the mirrors. Strength of field 3.5, that seems quite high. I think I'm more of a 2.5 safety rate. High rating kind of guy. I went up to 3K in the Clios, and yeah, that's put me out of position a little bit here in terms of what lobbies I'm going into.
The track temp is 24.
Nope, looks like we are going.
23 Celsius. 30 minutes. Okay, Clay, let's get this right. No fuck ups. Go.
Still got those brilliant starts.
Left side.
Ah, look, there's the new overlay that I've not been able to see yet.
Still there. Clear left.
I don't really know how they work. Am I clear on the left? got someone behind.
Car left. Still there.
So this
on
is the problem, because I've never driven with any other cars
still
on
there.
Track.
Clear left.
Clear left. That's what we needed. Just get to the back. And let's just work our way into this race a little bit. If I finish on the lead lap, it might be good, to be honest. I've never driven this car with 42 laps of fuel, so there's another issue. So yeah, I'm trying the iOverlay spotter, but I wasn't going to try it in the live race, but I just forgot I'd left it on. It's all very sensible, isn't it, back here at the minute. This is such a problem, because I don't remember the corners enough. Last thing you want to do is mess up someone's race with dust up ahead. I feel like I recognise Oscar Alonso Fernandez from the race last week. Kind of forgot this corner existed. Bloody lap. It's cleaning some of them. This is a corner I'm very much looking forward to following people in. Okay, so how many laps does the overlay think we're going to do? Said yet in the top left corner, still sussing it out. He thinks we're going to do 12. How many flaps of fuel have we got? Oh,
I have
to check in a second. Estimated laps 15, 14. Okay. My gut feeling was 40 litres before any science was applied, so. It's decent, I guess. That refuel calculator on the overlay saying I'll end with 9.9 litres. I overfueled by 10. Why did I let go of the brake halfway down there? Nice to keep up with these guys in front. They've taken out all the curves. Oh, I must be doing that so pedestrian. How many in this race? 18. Okay. So nearly a full lobby, that's good. There's some smoke. There's some smoke. Is there anything around this corner? I was half expecting to see a dead car. I should have stayed off the throttle for longer. Time in there, but I don't dare be brave, because every time I was brave in practice, I crashed. What was that? I had another overlay looking thing there. So slow.
Gap to Fernandez. Ahead is now 1.3.
1.3. This is a bit like last week. My first race will go up on YouTube, my last race will go up on YouTube. But bloody hell, I hope there's an improvement. He's gone. We've got a spinner.
There's an incident in Le Mans. Looks like it's Fernandez.
Is that called Le Mans, that corner? No way. Right, is there a way? I feel like I want to turn my steering ratio up a little bit.
The leader has just done a 214.28. That's a new fastest lap for Please. 214.00.
So Oscar's gone off there in a way that I've never gone off. I didn't know you could go off like P17. That, so I wonder if that's something to do with the curve. They're not completely getting away, are they?
Juice is now leading.
Maybe they are, and I've just not seen it. Well, that's the best I've done that today in the race.
You're gaining on the guy in front. The gap is 1.3.
We're gaining on the guy in front. Bloody hell. Really wish I could miss that apex every time. I've got like no spatial awareness of that corner. It's a long race, what can we talk about? I can tell you that I'm doing Ramadan. I've missed the first week of it. I'm late to the party, but it's because I had my birthday, so I didn't want to. I still wanted to eat, but I'm not Muslim, but I work with some guys who are, and I just wanted to see what it's like. So all day I've had hardly anything to drink. And then sun goes down.
Second down in
I've had a pre-race kebab.
Sector 3 is 0.6 off the pace.
And it's sitting heavy. So I'm just trying to get those excuses in case this doesn't go very well later. Concentration and what have you.
Smooth, come on, let the race come to us. We've got 20 minutes to go.
We've already done 10 minutes. So I've already achieved what I wanted, in a sense. I just need to do some laps. So I figured I'd join the race. felt like I did that quite well. The car looks like he's a little bit closer in front. Double left handers into brake before the three cones. Got it tight on this corner. I felt the car go a little light then, and I think that's what Oscar must have felt. Oscar's fallen back actually. He's fallen back a couple of seconds, so we're closing in on Jack. Maybe 16th is what we're aiming for here. It's not very exciting, is it? I really don't know how to do this. I'm wasting so much time there. 0.2 at least.
The front is now 1.2.
Relative.
That lap was at
2.16.45. Gained it back in. There we are. Oh, got a bit wide there. So the way to do that corner looks like you start out by following the track out wide. Oh, look how much time I lost through there. Wow. It wasn't just to Jack, it was to everyone, so that could be where I'm losing most of my time. This corner is just slam the brakes on, get down to third gear, do a 180. Easy. I'm sure I can mess it up. But. So I left that little hairpin quicker than Jack. Open card. God, inside pedals require a little bit of effort. Somehow muscle memory turning in a little bit later. The whole thing's a bit wrong. Right, here's the right hander that I'm not happy with. Look at all those cones strewn across the track. Well, across the grass. So an element of the overlay comes up. I don't really know what that means. I think it means instant overlays. Is that like
fastest lap
tells
for
you that
Graziani,
you're heading for an instant?
13.88.
Sure. Stay a little bit closer to Jack this time. Yeah, I didn't get that quite as wrong. And that felt a little bit better. I mean, 2.5 now. He shot off through there. Right, so let's play with the let's play with our own best lap. His Jack is gone. Barring a mistake.
P17.
And let's be honest, I'm more likely to make a mistake than he is.
Okay, Clay, 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes. That's half distance. Fuel levels are fine.
Fuel levels are fine. There we go. So that's confirmation. We have lost a bit. First few laps it suggested we'd be shy by 10. It's looking more like 5. The lower that number is and it's green, the better.
The gap in front is now 2.1.
Jump's gone. absolutely pegged it. Especially if we go wide like that. No idea. I know that was wrong.
The leader's just done it. 214.17.
214. That's 3 seconds that quicker than me, basically. That might be being kind, because I've done my best like every lap, have I? So he did a 114, and I've just done a 117 something? Wow, okay. Trying to brake a little bit later. Seems to be able to. Gears early, as early as you can in this car. Doesn't like you changing down. Doesn't let you do it too early. Jack has definitely fallen off the back of the pack ahead. Come on, relative. How is that not the quickest I've done that? That felt brilliant. What am I doing wrong there, everybody? Oh, I'm in the wrong gear here. I know what I've done wrong there. Let's just take this fairly straightforward. I've lost half a second through that whole section.
9 seconds.
Shows you how bad I've been doing it previously, because I haven't lost that much. We're going to see a 113 in this lap, in this race. So that's the best I've done that this race, I think.
You've just done
a 16.55. Is that a 16? Wow, that's quite good. Come on, Jack, slow yourself down, make the video interesting.
You've got half fuel left.
Laps to see if I can see what they're doing different to me. I know there's going to be setup related bits, but I'm sure I can still learn something from their lines. Maybe curbs that I should be climbing all over as opposed to avoiding. I haven't got a clue what that bar is that comes up. I I'm using the spotter because I saw online that if you're on a single monitor but you haven't got the ability of seeing left and right all the time through your peripheral, you're handicapping yourself, and I agreed with it. I never thought I'd have as much HUD as this, but it's just to try and stay informed, stay clean. I think there's just a lot more grip than what I've had in practice. Really like to catch up to Jack. Put him under some pressure. That felt like I was extremely wide. Tell you what, a 1X at this point, that's pretty good. I know I've not been racing any other cars, so it's probably been a little bit easier to focus on the track, but I thought I was going off there. no more talk about incidents. I've turned in too early. I think Jack was slipping back to us, and I've kind of let him go through this middle sector. I was slower again.
The leader has just done 2:14.00.
2.5 now. He's definitely falling back a bit. Carrying 5 litres too much fuel. That's very clever. Oh, look at the relative. Oh, I missed my gear shift. Oh. So, off throttle for longer,
that
stay tight.
16.46.
Got scared. This is where he's so much quicker than me. I've not helped by outbraking myself slightly. Yeah, look, 3 seconds now.
Is now in the lead.
Well, we've had a change for the lead. Very lucky not to get off track there, I have to say. We've got 6 minutes. I think I can bring that down to 2 seconds. There's no way he's had less practice than me. So I'm only going to get better, right? Don't know what my logic is there at all. We've missed the apex because we hit the curb, I like it. We're slower on the relative. I must have absolutely nailed it. Jack's getting away as well. Earlier, turn in a little bit sooner, off the brakes, keep our speed up. Well, that feels quicker. The car's getting a little easier to drive. It's down to 2.9. This sunset makes me think of the
okay, Clayton, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left.
The John Williams score from Star Wars. Stay off the throttle. I've touched the inside. Oh, I'm going to touch the outside. No, I don't know. I think, was I being too clever? Maybe. William Morris is 8 seconds gone. Fair enough.
That's good. consistency. Keep it up.
I can't help but feel like I can do, Jack. Come on. Uh-oh. And that's probably it. Sorry. Sorry, everybody. I know. I can't manufacture drama here. It's early in the week, so maybe someone's messed up their fuel.
The gap in front is now 3.5.
He's going to be feeling comfortable now. He can coast home. 2-3 laps left. He's not going to mess up now, is he? He hasn't messed up this far. I think I've relaxed as well. A little bit tough, but this is the first race of the week on a track we don't know.
Got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
It's still a relatively new car to me. Where that goes to this team. We're setting a benchmark. We've done a 1:16.4, which I think is my all-time best lap. I'll check that. Hang on. All-time best. 1:16.7, yeah, so my race lap here was quicker than anything I've done in practice. I find it scary that they're so much better. But that could be because this is an American track and all the Americans love it. And there were some good setups for it. We're going wide, don't think so. Kept it in that time. Maybe. Kind of a lot of speed in there.
Just 2 minutes left, 2 minutes to go.
Too tight. Yeah. We might have had a nice fight with Oscar if there wasn't a spin. We might have been a little bit quicker than them. Corners in, aren't there? This could be good for the old safety rating. I've said it now, so here comes an incident. Mark my words.
Fastest lap for Gratiani, 2:13.61.
There is. It's not only a 2:13, it's a 2:13.6 apparently. It looks like a 7.5 to me. 2:13.7. Wow, 2:13. Could have held that lap together, it would have been my quickest.
One more lap to go.
Yeah, it's too fast, and I was just terrified all the way on the back end of that. Okay, we're still green. We've got 3 laps left. so I've probably only overfueled it by 2 laps. So maybe a 38 litres, maybe we'll do 39 litres in the next super race. That should be enough. Oh, see, I carried too much speed around there. I should have held the brakes a bit longer. Ah, oh, damn it, I was on for a quicker lap. There's still a chance.
Incident in turn one.
Just practice turn one more time.
Place. There's the checkered flag.
Well, that's the best I ever did it by miles. Alright. That's it. I'll end the video there because I don't want it to break. Thank you, everybody. Look out for a second one of these later on. Cheers.